Say mashallah. Say alhamdulillah. Say Allahumma barak. Oh, you're awesome. Did you bring anything for our snack for the trip?
I got her something. Yeah, we're not supposed to be snacking.
Yeah, we're drinking.
She makes some good chowder, bro.
We're drinking a simpa so we can eat chowder.
Day I saw you. Oh my god. I get chills if I think about it. Look, I got goosebumps. I got goosebumps.
That's because of the AC.
No, that's because I love you.
I just think you're one of those weird people. John Buchke, you put your foot near the person and they end up stepping on
it. No!
I've never stepped on anyone's foot in my life.
Can you just admit that you were nervous because you were in love?
I was so confident.
You were not.
I'm to you like, did you hear that? You're like, yeah, she said that kini sori. I'm like, no, bro. She didn't say kini sori.
That's how positive I am. That's how positive I am.
I said, she just said to me, what the hell happened to you?
You don't ever lose money. Here you go, my brother. God bless you.
God bless you.
Thanks so much.
Take care.
Thank you.
No problem.
I was like, seriously?
You would say that
to someone? I was like, bro, she's shouting it across the street as well. Like, she didn't even say it to me in person. She's like across the road and she's screaming it to me.
I'm so dead. But what about its last days?
Oh, no. I was like, somebody take me somewhere. I was like, dealership, please. I'm not driving this back.
Wayoflifesq, keeping it 100.
This is how my vlog is starting. This is not Casey Neistat. This is SQ Neistat. You know I'm making a video, inshallah, about how Casey Neistat saved my YouTube channel? You guys don't even know. It's a cool story. I'll tell it one day, whenever I'm ready to. Or whenever I can think of another celebrity's name to put in my video. Who knows, huh? Who knows? The reason you are here with me today, alhamdulillah, inshallah, and with the permission of Allah, is you are accompanying me on a once-in-a-lifetime journey where I'm going to convince my wife to tell her hijab story on camera. Now, you have to remember something. My wife is not, she's kind of camera shy. And I find that like type of haya in her very nice. I do. It could be annoying sometimes. I'd be lying if I said it wasn't. But it's a nice quality now that I think about it, you know, out loud. Sometimes you got to say things out loud so you can make sense of them. You know what I mean? But inshallah, she's going to share her hijab story. And she's agreed to be documented on camera. Like, on camera. About her hijab story. And she plans to reveal her face completely. And I convinced her. So you're going to see her. You know, maybe like, oh my God, SQ, I get to see your wife. Why are you excited about that? I typed in Wayoflifesq. We wanted to watch a video on the TV. And it gave like other suggestions of what other people asked for. One of them said Wayoflifesq. The other one said Wayoflifesq wife. Next one said Wayoflifesq Ali Dawa. And Wayoflifesq tattoo. Wayoflifesq Ali Dawa. I don't know why these were the searchable things about my wife. That's weird. Okay, like, really? Tattoos? Okay, understandable. Maybe I need to make more content about that. Alhamdulillah. Thank you, YouTube algorithm, for showing me what I should be doing. That's... Say assalamu alaikum. Is it okay if I make this video? You want me to make this video? Is it okay? It's about mommy and you. Okay, she's stuck for words right now, but inshallah, may Allah bless you.
Yeah.
Hey, you look beautiful.
Yeah.
You look beautiful. Say mashallah. Say alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Say Allahumma barak.
Allahumma barak.
Oh, you're awesome. Show me your bow. Show me your bow. That's daddy's favorite color, green. Show me your green bow. Turn your head. No, don't take it off. Now, this kid is wild. I love you, okay? So, I want her to share her hijab story because I know there's a lot of sisters who watch the channel and probably would benefit from that as well. So, yeah, this video's title is going to be, I don't know. I'm thinking about titles already. This video's title is going to be My Wife Shares Her Hijab Story or something like that. Something about hijab story, you know? I'm sorry. Sometimes, like, I don't have an idea. You're right. But look at her. She never gives up. She's just counting. She entertains herself. I entertain myself. I remember Kanye had this line once. He said, with so much personality, what do you want from me? I can be by myself and enjoy the company. And, you know, I felt like I embodied that idea. And I still do. And may Allah guide him as well, too. You know what I mean? Everyone's going through stuff.
Good job, boys and girls.
Good job, boys and girls. What are you doing, Aya?
Obstacle course.
Huh? Obstacle course with what?
With
her fingers. Look, she has no toys. And she's just being creative. And instead of, you know, promoting that creativity, doing something more creative, we put them in a school. And it tells you when to get out, when to go to the bathroom. You know, she's in the house. She just decides to go to the bathroom. She just tells us she's going to the bathroom. She doesn't ask us our permission. She just goes to the bathroom. A kid has a need, go to the bathroom. You know? But just don't use the bathroom as a way to get out of class. You gotta be honest with yourself, you know? It killed your creativity. School's killing it. And, you know, maybe I might start a new YouTube channel. You guys don't know. I think I might. It's going to be called School of Life. And I just record my lessons that I give to my children, like so that people can, you know, who are being homeschooled or they're online, maybe they can watch my math class online on YouTube, right? The School of Life. And in that, they're going to learn about math. They're going to learn about life. Imagine that. I'd get fired probably if I said something crazy. I wouldn't say anything crazy, guys. I'd be saying some real stuff to my children. They're my, look how I said my children. They're my kids, you know? I want to look out for them. I love them. And you guys want to like send people to hell and say, oh, they're kafir, did this. Oh, you teach kafirs? Someone said that to me once. You teach kafirs? Is it a kafir school? Like, oh my God. You called the school a kafir. You called 6-year-olds, 5-year-olds kafirs. I went to that Shia Majlis video is coming out soon. Maybe, you know, maybe if I have a swamp day, I was thinking about this yesterday. Maybe if I have a swamp today where I don't feel like I'm able to record a video, I release another video that I haven't released before, right? So maybe it's a vlog video. Maybe it's just something just so that I want to release a video every day. But I also want you to see that side of me and that content too. This is just one side of me that you're seeing. But guys, I give real talks. I got invited to South Africa and I had amazing, amazing talks with children at their schools. Would you like to watch it? Even if you don't, I'm gonna still show it to you. Just because, like, I want you to see it. And I was so afraid. Honestly, and this is what goes back to my last video that I made, which would be linked over here somewhere. Watch that one too. You know, I think they're all beneficial. I was afraid to release those Ghana tapes and all that because, I don't know, I was insecure. But I'm not anymore. Whatever. Watch it, don't watch it, but I want you to see it. I think you'll benefit from it. It'll help someone. Right, beautiful? Yeah, we're killing creativity. You said you teach it at the Kafir school. God. I went to that Shia Majlis thing. I'm going to release that one too, guys. That's a popular one that you guys want to see. I'll show you one of those. It's good. I think I stayed very neutral in the middle about everything. And, I didn't bring my own personal views in listening to their story. That's the problem. People don't want to tell the story. They just want to tell their version of the story. How are we any different from fake news and media when we want to control what gets released about us because we don't want our image to be... I don't know what I'm talking about. What is she talking about, baby? What's up?
That's your paper.
That's my paper. Could you protect it for me? Can you hide it? And protect it for me, okay? Last time she used the marker and over here. You don't do that. You don't touch daddy's marker, okay? Show them your mask. Show them your mask. Oh, that's your mask. Is it dirty? You might need to clean it. Oh, God. I'm a bad dad. Oh, that's cute. Your children are unsanitary. That's all right. Let them be unsanitary. My wife takes care of my children. MashaAllah. It is almost your birthday. You know, that's the day Allah allowed you to be alive. Do you understand that, sweetheart?
It's on my birthday.
Inshallah. Listen to me, sweetheart. That's the day Allah, you know, delivered you in this world. But you were in Allah's, you know, thought process and creation from before time. He already said and decided that he was going to make you, my John. You are a product of Allah's wisdom, Allah's mercy. Not by chance, not by coincidence. There's so many things that could have happened to you. But Allah protected you and brought you here. And there, and you know what? I'm excited for you guys to see. Maybe this is just an overall vlog of the day about my wife's hijab story. Hey, beautiful.
Hi.
You're so blessed to have children. I'm going to show you some two of my friends today, inshallah. Two of my friends. I love them so much, wallahi. I see these. Can daddy make his video, baby? Is that okay? Can a daddy make his video?
Yes.
Thank you, baby. I see these two brothers, these little brothers of mine, and I get so proud of them. I look at them and I'm just like, you're gonna meet them. And they're so funny and fun. I love those kids.
Don't cry.
What did you say?
Don't cry.
Don't cry. Daddy's not afraid to cry for the sake of Allah. Never be afraid to cry for the sake of Allah.
You can come to the park, I think.
That'd be nice.
No.
I might make a 45-minute vlog. What do you guys think about that? Huh? Maybe what if the camera just never stops and you just see what happens in my life? I wish I had one of those things where I could just mount the camera, though. This might be a good time to invest in that. You know what I mean? I love those kids. Calling kids cat and God. I was saying all this real stuff to her. She paid no mind to it. That's how some people are. They behave like three-year-olds. Some people behave like three-year-olds, you know? And may Allah humble us. And, you know, may Allah allow us to humble ourselves. Have humility before He has to humble us. Wallahi, Allah sometimes has to humble us. And may Allah allow us to develop humility and seek forgiveness before He has to humble us. To teach us that. What do you think the solution is, huh? Leave these countries? Ah, this kafir land. There's a Muslim sister over there. Sorry for showing that. They're all wearing like a mask and hijab. So it's like, it's practically a niqab. Come on now. Come on now. There's so many sisters out there who I'm looking forward to who will take the next step to a niqab just because of COVID. Alhamdulillah for COVID. Alhamdulillah. Some women, some sisters are going to start wearing niqab, inshallah, because of COVID. Because they've seen how they look. She's covering her face too. Practically everyone's wearing a niqab, right? I think people who are not even Muslim see the value in niqab now. But a Muslim sister who wears the hijab, right? And then wears the mask all day. But you're practically wearing a niqab. What if you just change that intention for the sake of Allah? Then you don't even have to wear a mask. Probably you wear it underneath. Nonetheless, maybe. Maybe not. Maybe not. No, that is your mask. Whatever. That's what Allah did. That y'all don't even know. Allah created PPE. Yeah. In the Stone Ages, bro. People still wiping their asses. Islam has something to change the world. People act like, oh, we're going to Mars. We're going to the moon. 4K video, that's still wiping your asses. Islam has the ability to change the world. You're like, oh, women are oppressed. No, Allah made a PPE mask for them. Germs wouldn't spread. And their honor and beauty is being protected. An asset to the world is being protected. My daughter wouldn't be here without my wife. Wallahi, I did nothing. What did I do? I just, you know, did what I had to do. And then my wife did all the work. Obviously, Allah's wisdom and mercy, He took care of everything. But my wife did all the work. What did I do? Gotta sit here and make a video? Show you her. Hey, beautiful.
I made a mess.
Just don't make a mess. Look what she be doing in the car, guys. Look what she be doing in the car. Can you see that? Hey, you don't draw in the car, okay?
Okay.
I love you. You won't do it again? Don't eat that. Don't eat that. That's not a joke. Don't eat that. That's the problem. Remember when she was climbing the little, like, umbrella? She thinks it's a joke. It's not a joke. You know what I mean? people liked the last video. It was like a vlog style reminder. I'm just like, where's my wife, you ask? Were you thinking that? It took me 13 and a half minutes, nearly 14, approaching 14 minutes before I even told you where my wife is. I'm talking about she wants our hijab story. I'm going to have her share it. And she's not even here. So we are going to Brooklyn right now to see a family friend. It's my wife's basically best friend, childhood friend. She lives in Brooklyn. So my wife is going to go see her. We see her. We have a good relationship with them, mashallah. And, you know, I love her children. We play 2K. My wife's going to go out and do her thing. So we're stopping by to get a little gift for them. You know, you can't go empty-handed to people's homes, bro. What the hell's wrong with you? Dude, that's bad manners, bro. Hey, sweetheart. You want my attention? That's the truth, right? That's where they act out. They're like, look at me, daddy. What's up, beautiful? What's up? I love you. Hey, I took off your shoes. Show them your feet. Show me your toesies. Show your toesies. Her dogs are out. Your dogs are out. As soon as we get in the car, this child takes off her shoes. I don't know why. I do too, though. My dogs are out. The puppies are out. So she gets it from her father. That's my baby. 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 I love you. I love you. Oh, man. Can you believe that daddy has to go back to work? I'm going to miss seeing your face. Can't be. We got to change. We got to bring the change in America. We got to bring the change in our communities. The UK is doing a great job. Oh, no, they're not. But the Dawah, yeah, they are. Bro, you can't go to a mall without a prayer area. You know how awesome that is? I know franchises that are not even like Muslim-owned franchises, but because they've all... Hey, sweetheart. Hey, sweetheart. You're speaking over daddy. And being rude. Okay. I love you. Okay, just be a little quiet, please. Thank you. I love you. She caught my energy, you know what I mean? So, you know, there's non-Muslim franchises that have halal, you know, branches in highly predominant Muslim areas. You know, I think that that's an amazing thing that Muslims have done. People just have this, no, Muslims aren't, you know, adhering to the Quran and the Sunnah. Well, they're adhering to one thing. What if that's the seed that we keep watering and develop them into other things? You can't lose hope. Kafir kids, these are beautiful children. Did you not see the Uyghur social experiment? Go watch that. Who recorded that Uyghur social experiment? My student. She's not a Muslim. So she gets no reward in this? Okay, she gets zero reward in this. Okay, guys, you win. I'm clapping with one hand. Oh, man. I love seeing you guys timestamps. I love when you guys put the timestamps on your favorite moment. Look at her. I love you. Okay, Mary John, thank you. She just gets so hyped. She catches my energy. Christians would say she caught the Holy Spirit. No, that's not a Holy Spirit. This isn't a Holy Spirit. We're not possessed. May Allah protect us from possession. The Holy Spirit, you're saying an angel enters inside of you? Come on. It can't be an angel, so it has to be a jinn. Come on, a mischievous jinn that just wants to dance inside of you. Oh, man. I love you guys so much. Because, Mary John, you should laugh. And you should cry. And you should express emotions.
Why?
You should express your emotions. I think the problem is a lot of people are very uptight. They don't want people to see them in a wrong light. You know, like I've done videos where I've said something that my spit is over here. You know, I don't edit it until I fix it up and redo a scene. I used to do things like that, and that's wrong. If I have a booger showing over here, oh damn. So 17 minutes into the video, oh, I got a booger. I'm sorry, guys. That's just what it is. If I had to do a bud, I had to do a bud, bro. Sometimes I burp. I don't mean to be gross, and I wouldn't do that on purpose, but I'm just saying, you know, some people are just so uptight that they only want to show themselves in a positive light. My wife's here, mashallah. Hey, you're going to see it from far. Far. So my wife, she's looking at me like, oh man, this man has the camera out. I see mommy too. Oh, she got grapes. I hope she bought us some snacks for the trip. Well, like, she's a real one if she did. But I still love her if she didn't. Hey, baby. Oh, that looks beautiful. Look at this. What did we get? What is this? A bonsai tree?
No,
a cacti. This looks beautiful. That's a nice gift.
Mommy!
Give them.
Okay.
Okay, now let me ask you a question. Did you bring anything for our snack for the trip?
I got her something. Yeah, we're not supposed to be snacking.
Oh, what do we have to eat?
We're going to have the drink and that's
it. Oh, we're going to have a drink. We're trying to be better. Should we put that in the trunk?
So I just want you to hold on to this because I've got to put stuff in
there. Anything for you, babe. Let me drop this.
Stay in there.
Hold this? Okay. Can I have a strawberry, though? Am I allowed to have that?
Yeah.
So we got some fruits for them. Is this a bad sanitary? That's do and hair. Aw. Give me a little gift. We go to the dollar store. Is that some dollar store?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. The dollar store is cool. Getting kids stuff from the dollar store. That's cool. Is it wrong if I try to eat one of these strawberries? Or is it like the amount of the people that we bought the intention to give it to? What do you think it is? I don't know. Hey, babe. Do you think it's wrong for me to eat one of these strawberries?
Yes, it is.
Are you a mufti or something? I need a fatwa. All right. See, you don't need... Some things are just common sense. Some things are just common sense. But I'm not saying you don't need scholars. Don't take this out of context. I'm not saying any of that. Oh, that looks beautiful. Is it you giving her a gift too? Let me see that gift. Oh, that's so beautiful. Is this hand sanitizer? Wow, Gabi Zamana, yeah. That we have to give people hand sanitizer as gifts.
No, this is hand wash. This is a hand sanitizer.
Okay, but like, is that a gift?
It's a gift, yeah.
Oh my God, can you believe that Zia Zamana get our gifts are hand sanitizers now?
Well, she likes hand washes and
stuff. That's nice. Okay, this is going to be the brown bag. I can't, it's on the floor.
Wait, let me put it in here. That's
okay, now I just want to say, in the back of my mind, I know that Haya has somehow made a mess in the back with the chips. But I have to remember something, that's my fault. Because I should have opened it for her and not given her, a thing. She's not as Siani as my other child, Dua, who's on a trip right now, if you guys recall. If you guys are wondering. None of you asked that, though. But let me see if she made a mess. No. No mess. You're a good girl. Such a good girl, mashallah, probably. Okay, a little bit, but you'll clean that, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna clean that.
I believe in you.
Yeah, I'm gonna clean that.
Oh, you're so awesome. Okay, this is our food. Right here. Slim fast. Maybe Zamana, yeah. Man, don't slim fast. You gotta get it together for the sake of Allah. That's it. I gotta start running. I gotta start doing stuff, becoming more active, have a healthier lifestyle, do what I love with who I love, for who I love, you know, and just do it for the sake of Allah, who I love. Okay, are you gonna wear these glasses or no glasses?
Bro, the reason we're drinking the slim fast.
Yeah. Oh. I thought you had your mask on. Oh, sorry, you don't have your mask on. I'm sorry. Go ahead, baby. I'm sorry. Hey, I'm sorry about that. I thought you had your mask on.
No.
I'm sorry, but look how comfortable you just got.
No,
so
I
proud
didn't
of you.
We know we're drinking the slim fast, so we can eat chawal when we go to our
Yes. This lady, who is my I'm not gonna say the name, so I feel like I shouldn't know her name, right? Who's my wife's family friend, like childhood friend. She invites us, we go to her house in Brooklyn and just see her family and go hang out with her. Me, I go hang out with the kids, play some 2K. But most importantly, they get to bond and stuff like that, which is good. But remember, your mask has to be on in the car. Remember, I'm making the video. I want to make that video about my wife's hijab story. And you said, what did you say to me? Did you say that to me? If you don't want me to do it, I won't do it.
No, I'm just like, we're going to be driving. I'm gonna
That's okay, that's going to be fun. That's okay.
We could do it at her house.
Think so?
Yeah.
Okay. No problem, babe. No problem.
I don't wear it. We can sit near the AC, but right now, I don't want to be wearing
That's
it while I'm driving.
But isn't the AC on in here, too? I'm sorry for asking.
The reason is because I have to take my hijab off right now and put the mask on.
Oh, see? Right? That's so insensitive of me. I'm sorry, babe.
If you want me to show people my hair, that's...
Okay, what if I just put the thing over here? Is that okay? I'll blur your face out. Don't worry. Is that all right? Huh, babe? Is that okay? Hey, I've been doing your hair the whole time. Don't give me that. You got to do some sacrifice for me. Is that okay? Okay, that's fine. Is that better? Is that your approval? That's your approval. Okay, bismillah. Are we going to chug it or sip it? Which one is it?
You can sip it. I'm driving. I'm going to drink it now.
Oh, damn. Okay, it's a race. Oh, I'm going to win. Don't choke. Say, you didn't even say bismillah, mommy. That's messed up, mommy. Bismillah.
Bismillah.
You're drinking this like it's some rabri feluda. Only the real ones know what a rabri feluda is. Guys, I have an awesome video of rabri feluda in Pakistan. I have some Pakistan vlogs. Should I release some Pakistan vlogs, babe?
When are you going to release my dad and the sushi?
Oh, should I release that one first? Say that's the first one I should release.
Yes.
Tomorrow's video is going to be that. Say no more. If my wife says it, gets it.
My dad's been waiting over a year to watch it.
Oh, what? Okay, if my wife says it, it happens. Bismillah. Okay, but I'm going to keep the camera like that. It's easier for my hands. Let's get out of here, babe. I love you, John. Thank you for doing this. Thank you for being so thoughtful. For that meal, I reward you.
Yeah, I got the glass hand soap and the
I seen the glass yesterday. Thing in our house though.
No? Yeah, I got it yesterday.
For Valkyrie's.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
And then when I brought it home, I started getting like, oh, I should have got two. I should have got myself one.
That's beautiful.
It's nice, right? It's one of those ones that you refill. The glass one, so you just refill it.
Oh, you're so thoughtful, mashallah. Seriously, and you allow me to be a passenger in here? That's just amazing. What is that jumbo shrimp, 2 pound lobster? What is that?
It's raw.
It's raw?
Mm-hmm. It's per pound, 25 per pound. They're not cooking it for you, bro. They're selling it per pound, man.
Mommy!
Papu, you have no idea how funny you are.
Oh, salmon would be tasty.
Valkyrie makes proper good food, bro.
Where did we eat salmon? Where did we go to when we had really nice salmon? Oh.
Where?
That place where? In New Jersey.
What place?
The buffet place.
The buffet place is good, they shut all those buffets down.
Yeah, I'm just saying they had a really nice...
You know what buffet we need back? Come on, I'm not going to even say, let's see how well you know me, what I'm about to say. Which buffet do we need back?
The sushi.
You know it. You know it. That's our place. May Allah remove COVID. Just not just for all the people who could benefit and life can be a little more normal, but for that sushi place to open again, bro.
I mean, they're doing takeaways, but I'm praying those prices.
No way. It's a buffet, fresh sushi. That's another thing we need to prepare for. Like, if we know a week in advance that we're going to go get sushi... We should like cut out and be more strict with ourselves. You know what I mean? Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it makes sense.
That's what we're doing right now.
Yeah. So that we can eat the chawal.
Yeah, we're drinking.
She makes some good chawal, bro.
We're drinking a simpan so we can eat chawal.
Oh, Allah Mubarak. Make dua for the new house too, Babu. Please make dua for it. It can't just be me. Everyone has to be making dua and be on board. Is everything good still?
Yeah.
Wow, my ways were still on, yeah? You know what would suck? If the entire time there's no audio being recorded. You know what I mean? How crazy would that be? What, do you think I would still release it?
We'd have to say
Do you think I would still
we'd
release
have to
it?
Say a lip sync.
We'd have lip sync.
I don't know what I said.
Oh my God, I forget how funny you are. I'd say, Papu, like ever since we lived together, you got funnier.
Oh, please.
I think you got funnier.
You know I was cracking. Yeah. Right? I feel like I got less funny.
No, shut up. Oh, my God. Listen to me, Bubble. The day I saw you, I knew I loved you. The day I saw you, oh, my God. I get chills if I think about it. Look, I got goosebumps.
That's because of the AC.
No, that's because I love you.
Yeah, and then I stepped on your toe and you were like, oh, I don't think I want to marry you.
Yeah, that was almost a deal breaker, babe. That was almost a deal breaker.
I just think you're one of those weird people. John Buchke, you put your foot near the person and they end up stepping up.
No.
I've never stepped on anyone's foot in my life.
Can you just admit that you were nervous because you were in love?
I was so confident.
No, you were not. You know what your old confidence was? It used to be a wall. It used to be a defense mechanism. I feel like you now have real confidence. Now you have, I would argue, and forgive me, I don't try to think that I'm just trying to say things through you and decide for you, but I mean that. I feel like you've grown so much as a person. Wouldn't you agree? Right? I feel like when you go back to the UK, people don't even recognize you. You look different. You wear the hijab now. You weren't always wearing the hijab. Remember that lady who I thought gave you a compliment? Oh. What did you say? Babu, no. I thought she gave you a call. I was like, what did I say?
Yo.
Okay, what happened?
You're
tell me.
You're like bloody naughty walking along. Yeah. La, 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 la. Woman cusses me out. And
what
I'm
did
like,
she say?
I'm to you like, did you hear that? And you're like, yeah. She said that Kini Sony. Yeah. I'm like, no, bro. She didn't say Kini Sony.
That's how positive I am. That's how positive I am.
I said, she just said to me, what the hell happened to you?
Yeah.
You used to be so beautiful.
Oh. All I heard was like Sony or something like that. Okay, this is a hack. Sorry, I just need to be out of my seatbelt for a second. It'll not protect me. So I can get myself right. Is that bad? Is this... Is am I setting a bad example for children, people right now? I am. Astaghfirullah.
What are you
I should be a leader. I just needed to take my seatbelt off.
Why would you need to take your seatbelt?
Because I felt uncomfortable. But that's stupid.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
Oh my god, that could kill me. God forbid. But boy, I saw an act almost
when
an accident.
When have you ever taken your belt off now? In
you know why? Because of my pit.
You're shooking your own. I'm not...
Me while, yeah, be careful, be careful.
While you were doing
oh my god, astaghfirullah. I love you so much. I love you so much. You're so funny. You're so funny. But you've changed, honestly. That lady doesn't know what she's talking about. She said the kitty sorry ho titi. That's too funny.
No, bro. Oh. She said, I didn't recognize you.
Say it in the lingo. Say it in the lingo.
Kitni soni on is here, chitti.
She said that?
Up there, right?
Up there. She said that?
Yeah, she said, chitti on is here, tu tore kia, le tu kia. And I'm like, oh. Like,
what did you say? All I heard was Sony, this and that. I'm like, whoa, yeah, she just gave you a compliment.
Genuinely. She don't give me no compliment. She was like, yo, what happened to you?
Okay, so wait, what did you say?
I said, oh,
look at your humility. Wait, once upon a time, you would have like
cussed her. Ripped her.
You would have ripped her.
I said, look at yourself. Like, you ain't no beauty queen. No. Do you know what I mean?
No,
I
you're a better said, person than
yeah,
that.
I was like, you know what?
That's, right. That's your honor. Look how funny this is.
And then the thing is, like,
Allahu Akbar. God bless
just
you.
Like, I was like, seriously?
You would say that
and
to someone?
I was like, bro, she's shouting it across the street as well. Like, she didn't even say it to me in person. She's like across the road and she's screaming it to me.
I'm so dead. I'm so dead.
I'm like, people are like hearing this and they're like, yo, Kini sorry when you see what's happened to her now.
Oh
and,
my God.
You know, when you
so
said
So I'm
it
thinking,
to me,
I'm thinking like, if she said sorry something, so I'm like, it must sound good. But wow.
Yeah, it was... Partially, it was because I was wearing a hijab.
Really?
Yes. Because when
so even in the Muslim community, it looked like you were like you've taken a step back, right? It's like you've taken a step back in beauty in the Muslim community.
Yeah.
Isn't that weird? Hey, don't kill us. Come on. SubhanAllah, we have children on board.
Like
you
the bus driver can see me coming, but he's still gonna like try and squish us.
He's stressed out. It's a cry for help. We have to respond with love. I should have got out and asked, is the day okay, Papu? That's what we should be doing.
And then the other bus would have talked us from behind.
Papu, on my way to the masjid, guess what? Yes. I almost saw an accident. This lady, this Benz, Papu ran a stop sign.
Oh, God.
Not a stoplight, a stop sign.
Yeah.
Papu, is the lady coming. Papu.
They hit or they...
No, missed, subhanAllah. Bachitogi. Maybe, Papu, I had some angels with me who helped out, subhanAllah. I'm going to the masjid, I brought some barakah to them. Papu, like, she said, I'm sorry, it was my fault, I didn't see, I wasn't
paying
attention.
Damn right, it's your fault, you didn't stop.
Oh my God. That's why you be running stop signs sometimes. You gotta be careful.
I never.
Papu, you've done it sometimes.
I've only done it when I haven't realized it's stop
signs. Papu, that's why you run it, because you don't realize it. It's not intentional. You don't run stop signs on potential, but it's a lapse of judgment sometimes.
No, she ran it, babe. Like, local, I don't. If I'm not local, then if sometimes, like, I'm paying too much attention to something else and I miss it.
Papu, let me tell you something. You and the bache drive me. Honest to God, you drive me. You know? Literally, you drive me, and you drive me from my focus as well. But you literally do drive me as well. You know? And this is such a blessing. Good job with this, babe. We used to be here, having the easy pass, doing all this stuff, guys. So in New York City, for those of you who don't know, we have like an easy pass. When we have to pass through certain bridges and things like that, we gotta pay money for it. And it's quite expensive here in New York, wouldn't you agree? So we have this thing that we have to do. But I didn't have the thing to stick it up here, so I'd put it up here, I'd do this, and it's an inconvenience, but
it's not those £1.50 tolls.
Yeah. It's like $8 sometimes. So anyways, and you know, subhanAllah, you had the foresight to do this for us.
Yeah, because I'm like driving and I'm like, where is it?
Yeah. And you know what? I realized this. My responsibility is to remove and lessen your anxiety and not give it more. And sometimes I give you more anxiety. I'm really sorry about that, John. Seriously. Mm-hmm. It's not for the camera. I could flip this over. Honest to God, babe. I'm sorry. Do you understand me? I'm sorry, okay? I don't mean to. I just want you to have more confidence than you give yourself. I want you to give yourself more credit than you do, okay? John, like, you're an awesome driver. If this thing goes off, this sound goes off, it goes off. You have the foresight. You are smart and intelligent enough to do that. I love you so much.
Love you too.
Hey, why you make that face? You made a face just now.
I didn't. I'm just thinking about all that shopping I'm going to do at Primark.
Oh my God, you go to Primark.
Yep.
Oh, mashallah. You should bring me something. Bring me a gift from there. Surprise me, okay?
I brought 200 cash with me, so you don't find out how much I spend.
I love you so much. Papu, it's all yours. I love you. I love you so much. I love you so much. And you know, and by the way, I don't love you to the degree where I know Allah can't. Papu, if you love someone, Papu, think about this. Doesn't Allah test you with what you love? We love who He tests us with it. Slip fast. But Papu, we love each other. Allah's going to test us with each other.
You know, I only got
we can't give each give up on each other.
Obviously.
We can never give up on each other.
Hey, babe.
I'm the halal dina Tokyo. I'm like the the practicing male halal dina Tokyo.
Yeah, but I'm not like a husband.
No. You're the sin of this. No. This is our relationship. There's no cuts. There's no nothing. It's just us driving. And make dua for us. Say Allahumma barak. You know, I need to be better with my quls. Making sure I read it on you guys. Read it on myself. I'm putting my family at risk. You know, it's like I'm exposing people to COVID. It's like haters are the new COVID. You get me? Hate their ayn, their nazar, their, you know, their evil eye. It's like COVID. You understand? It's like a spiritual disease. It's like a spiritual thing that could happen to you. May Allah protect us. We gotta wear masks. Our mask is the quls. You get me? Our PPE is the quls. Yeah.
Oh, I ordered dua and haya, those masks that fit behind the ears.
Oh, mashallah.
I think they're supposed to come today.
Okay. Maybe we get something printed on them. What do you think?
It's a plain mask with like little stars on them. But I'm like, for now, they need what haya?
They got the same puppy book for me.
It's a whiteboard so you can write your name.
For me?
One for you and one for dua.
You know what we should do?
Yeah, but it's going to be in the car. And when dua comes tomorrow, I'll give it to her.
Inshallah,
you know, she comes
tomorrow. Inshallah, you know, drive home safely.
You know, dua gets upset if she doesn't get the same things as you. Yeah, what were you saying, babe?
Nothing.
I was telling you about that lady.
Papu, I feel like I have two genuine, like, best friends, right? Best friends, right? And I consider this other brother a best friend, but that person I want to keep between me and Allah, okay? I'm not going to say that person's name. There's some other people too, but I'm going to keep them between me and Allah. But just for this example, I'm going to show you someone. Papu, me and Shuaib were talking up all night last night. Just through voice notes, Papu. And Papu, he is so funny. Papu, he said something about giving dawah to a vampire. And John, I just lost my mind. I lost my mind. And now you telling me right now about the lady who was saying all those things about the sortie and this and that. But look how, Papu, and the reason I'm saying this to you is, Papu, because you guys bring joy in my life. Thank you. You know, like,
yeah, but Shreve is funny though.
Shreve is proper funny. Because he comes from your end.
But you know what it is?
Yeah.
Sometimes I feel like he's not being funny. He's dead serious. It's so funny. Like, what he says is funny.
Yeah, because like, I play the voice notes in front of you.
Like, he might not think it's funny. He's actually saying something serious, but yeah. It's hilarious.
I play so anyone who really voice notes me, I play it from my voice. You know, and this is where a lot of, you know, I don't know if I call myself a dai. Do I call myself a dai? Babu, am I a dai?
Well, if you're promoting the message of Allah, then you are.
I am. But, you know, to some, I'm not.
To some extent, we all are. We all are. Islam.
Definitely. Papu, I was made to feel, not going to say any names, I was made to feel like I wasn't qualified to do this.
Yeah, well, if I saw this person, I'll give them a piece
of mind. No, it's okay. It's okay. Because you know what? We need to learn humility from this.
To pack some bags.
And
take Chachi Chacha with him.
No. May Allah bless us. May Allah bless us. You're ride or die. You're ride or die. I love that.
Remember my brother left you once at the masjid when you fell? And I ripped to my brother. Yeah, I got so angry.
You got so upset.
I said, you took this guy. He doesn't know where he's going. And then you have the audacity to leave him. He said, oh, no, I couldn't see him. I said, do you, like, does that not make sense to you? He doesn't know where he's supposed to go. His phone doesn't work here. I said, clearly you've just abandoned him.
Hey,
I'm sure you'll find his way back. I said, how
did I, did I find my way back?
Babe, you did, but that's
hey,
not.
But can we just talk about the real issue about how you got worried about me?
Yeah, no, I was worried
can
about
we talk
you.
About that?
The principle, it's the principle.
Can we talk
like...
about that? I don't care. That was so funny. I got to know your area. You know how badly I missed the UK trip? You know, Papu, I look forward to that UK trip as much as you do, right? To see Shuaib and stuff. Look at you, Papu. How proud I am of you. How do you? Tell me why am I proud of you. Let's see if you know me. Let's see if you know me and see why I'm proud of you.
Because when that lady said that, how old? Between Miss Honey, I didn't punch her lights
no,
out.
So that's obviously one of them. I'm talking about this incident right now with you driving. Tell me why am I so proud of you? Let's see how bad you know me.
How bad I know
you? Well, how, you know, how good you know me, obviously, but how bad. Like, let's see if you can. Last time you did with the sushi, you were telling why am I so proud
because
of you right
I'm,
now?
I'm just driving and talking to you. I'm not worrying about the traffic or something. Like
thank you. And you know
normally
what?
I say to you, why is there traffic?
Yeah,
I think Bapu, we should take another
route. And it just feels so comforting, doesn't it? Right? And you know, it's another secret reason. Maybe I just keep that between me and Allah. Just so that you get a reward on the Day of Judgment for it, for making your husband happy. I love you so much. And you look so beautiful. You're right. I shouldn't be even trying to show you. This is all they're going to see. Just that eyebrow. That's all you get to see. And a little bit of the hair. Papu, I dyed your hair. Come on. Can we talk about that for a second? Papu, I really,
oh,
I legit did it.
Listen,
come on.
I went from
no one's ever going to see it. But can people at least know how good a job I did?
You did a good job.
MashaAllah.
Listen, I went from like a auburn to a peroxide blonde.
Yes.
To a white.
And I liked her as a peroxide blonde.
To a whitewash blonde. From a whitewash blonde.
It was a whitewash blonde.
Right? I was blue and then half green.
You look like Harley Quinn.
Yeah. And then I went from the blue and the green.
Or the Joker.
To a white blonde.
Look at this jungly and the unsafe jungly back there. Hey, you got caught on camera. Allah was watching you too. Get back in your seat. That's naughty. Allah doesn't like unsafety. Allah wants you to be safe, Haya. Allah gets naraz if you're unsafe. You understand? Haya, do you understand? I love you. Please, Haya, be safe, okay? Sit down. Thank you.
So in the space of 2 weeks,
I
went from those shades to gray and ash blonde. And
I'm sorry for
I'm
cutting
gray.
You off, by the way.
So now it's like a gray.
John, listen to me. I'm flipping this over just so you know that it's not about this. Just know when I genuinely say, I'm not saying this for the camera. I hope you don't think I'm saying it just for the camera. This doesn't mean anything to me. Do you understand me, John? I love you, okay? I get so emotional when I talk to you.
You've been quite emotional these few days. How are you?
I have. I feel like I'm gaining perspective. And I just ask Allah's forgiveness and I ask Allah to guide me and to forgive me. And, you know, to bless us. You know, John? Seriously, bless
Give
us.
Give me my sunglasses, please.
It's right here, John. Of course, that's my job now. Now that my wife drives, man. You know the original, what was the original intention of my YouTube channel? Do you remember? Tell me if you remember. Maybe you don't. It's okay if you don't.
Your original?
Original intention of this YouTube channel when Shuaib pulled me back in the day.
It was to give dawah and promote Islam.
But how was I going to do it? Remember I bought the white screen and I was doing those
types
of videos?
You were just going to do where you sit down and you do the videos where you talk to the camera.
Who was my niche? Who was it directed to directly? Who?
Non-Muslims.
No, it was to Muslim men. Remember? That was the advice. All my things were to Muslim men advice. This like a brothers only. Remember that,
yes.
Right? Now it's evolved,
okay,
obviously.
When you used to do the waxing and stuff when we were at Bronx.
Yes, yes. If it's about, maybe I should release those as a bonus footage.
That was like, 6 years ago?
Yeah. Wow, Papu. Wait, do you think I should release those videos just for like the kicks of it?
The one where you did the waxing and your nose starts leaking was pretty funny.
Yeah, that was pretty funny. You know, but things evolve. You don't change. You're not fake. You evolve. Things change. We're all on our own journeys. I think this is such a cool angle, Papu. They get to see like the sky and stuff, right? Isn't that nice, mashallah? I hope you guys are enjoying this. This is not a Casey Neistat level vlog, okay? I can't do it like that, but I'm going to do it like SQ Neistat. Casey Neistat saved my YouTube channel. Is that a true statement?
Yes.
Listen to what my wife just said. And if you're a real one, you've watched it to this point right now. And I said it in the beginning where one of my videos when I'm inspired is going to be Casey Neistat saved my YouTube channel.
Yeah, you were going
to... So don't even say that story, but is that a true thing?
Yeah.
Is that clickbait? I'm just trying to use Casey. It's not clickbait. Bubble, be honest to God. Honest to God. Do I clickbait people? Be honest. It's okay. I'm not going to be upset.
Sometimes if you look at the title, it can come across as clickbait.
Okay,
but the video isn't clickbait.
It's not. So, okay, what makes it seem clickbait, but it's not clickbait?
I guess the pictures.
Okay.
Because it's like, oh, and I open it like the, oh, mashallah, so then when I click on it.
Yes.
You know, but.
But if you watch it, is it that?
No.
So is that like a halal clickbait? Is that, would you consider that a halal clickbait? She's not a mufti, but that, I feel like that's a halal clickbait. Yeah. No, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's like, you know, I lost my train of thought.
It's okay. I'm sorry if I cut you off.
Can you switch off for the fuck?
Okay. You know what? My wife does get cold on her feet. I should be better about that. But and maybe next one we get the dual. Maybe we get the dual one in the next one.
I'm wearing papla on my feet, so.
Yeah, you're best. I'm sorry. And listen, I never delivered on that
massage.
I didn't deliver on that. I'm so sorry. don't. Forgive me. May Allah bless us, man, and just forgive us and continue to increase.
You okay, Lalo?
Baby, you good? Eating chips? Allah bless you. Did you say Bismillah? Say it again.
Bismillah. Did you not find your zombie? Where was it? Under the sofa. Okay, when we go back home, I'll try and look for it for you.
You know, people find Haya quite funny and entertaining. You know, someone wrote that in the comment section. He said, you know, Haya is legit funny. She's funny, Papu. She has like a proper personality. I'm not trying to like pump her in. She's going to be in the next movies. Like, it's not that, but I'm just saying, I think she's proper funny.
Looking at it from the outside is funny, but as a parent, yeah.
It's frustrating.
Yeah.
It's frustrating,
when
but you know
what?
When
you just put the clothes on and they're dirty, then it's annoying.
It is annoying.
When you brush their hair and they rip it out, it's annoying.
It is annoying.
When you're trying to feed them and they're throwing it around and they don't want it, it's annoying. And then an hour later, they're like, oh, I'm so hungry. And it's like,
it is annoying. Let me tell you something. That's called a cry for help. That's all they're doing. And if we respond with a complaint back to them, then our response is a cry for help too. We have to come to a place from love. Papu, listen. And this is what I learned, Papu, that there's two types of conversation only. One is a cry for help or it's a place of love. Anytime someone says something to you, it's either a cry for help or a place of love. Papu, everything you've said to me is from, not a cry from help, it's from a place of love.
Look at this.
That's a cry for help. Right? That's a cry for help. Like, but look how you responded. But look how you responded,
there was
right?
There's not even space for them to even get in.
But they got it.
Yeah,
right?
I was pricked.
But you know, but that's a response of love. You know what's a cry for help? Would have been a what?
If I started owning.
Exactly.
No, I mean, the thing is, that's an impossible maneuver. Like,
it is. Look at that car.
There was no space to get in.
I like that. What do you think about that discovery car, Papu?
No.
Assembly? It
looks like a hearse.
That one? Let's get closer to it. We get whatever you want, John. You know, you motivate me. You keep me going. I was reading this book, Papu, called The Dip, the one that you ordered for me. What were you going to say? I cut you off.
I liked my BM.
Originally?
Yes.
But what about this one? Not more. You don't like this more than that?
I don't want to say more. Obviously, I like it.
Do you feel like you just had an emotional attachment to that?
Yeah, because I got used to it and it was like, you know, it was my little...
But if you had to go back to that, would you?
Yeah.
You would?
I liked it, yeah.
Wow.
It was luxurious.
I love it. It was
luxurious.
It was. Our old car was a 2006... A BMW 750 Li.
Remember when the sensors weren't even working and we were trying to park it in that tight gap?
Yeah.
And
it held us
it.
Down.
Yeah,
but
it.
What about its last days?
Oh, yeah. I was like, somebody take this. I was like, dealership, please. I'm not driving this car on the bloody motorway.
that's too funny.
I am not going to drive this car back on the motorway because it is going to clunk out. The whole way there, you go over 50, the whole car's vibrating.
Oh, my God. So basically, it needed a new timing chain. Right? That's what the car needed. And that was going to cost like, what, $5,000 or something.
Yeah.
Something stupid like that. I'm just like, yo, it's not worth it. This vehicle officially has now, I've had it for how long? 3 years?
Just over three.
Three and a half years. And it's been good to me, alhamdulillah. I bought it from an auction. It had one owner prior to this?
Yeah.
One owner, right? And it came from a dealership.
It was in
very excellent condition.
Excellent shape.
It had how many thousand miles? 90,000 miles?
I think.
Like, it had like 90, 91,000 miles on it, right? 2006.
And it was clean. Like,
nice. Gosh, clean. And from the inside, very nice tan interior, beautiful, gorgeous.
I think after we used it, it was like...
Nah, it was... I didn't take care of it as much as I should have.
It's kind of like, and, you know, the
back seats. It's 750 is not the car for a kid. You know, it's not there. You know, they need probably maybe even this one. They're writing on crayon. I showed you guys. Okay, anyways. But it was good. It was good, mashallah. But it was getting dated because it didn't have certain technologies that my sister car has, who has an MDX, mashallah. So we were like, okay, it's a timing chain. Why spend $5,000 to fix this car, which if I even try to sell on a good day, it's not worth that much, you know? So instead, we took it to the dealership. We wanted to get a different car. And I made dua, papu, and umrah for this. Is that, papu, it meant a lot to me, you know, a nice car for the family.
You know what was like, what I didn't like was,
yeah,
even while the car was doing all right, you just kept making these.
No.
Yeah, you did.
You know what? You're right. I did.
Today I did this. Oh, did. You know, but, tomorrow
papu,
it might.
Can
and I was like, yo,
I was trying to get a new car. I was trying to get a new car. But no, it wasn't just that. I'm breaking out, subhanAllah. Okay, you know what it was? Can I just tell you? I saw the signs in the car that you and I didn't see until they showed them bigger. I saw it. Didn't I say, papu, it vibrates funny?
Yeah.
Didn't I say, I said it, didn't I? Papu, months before it happened, true? And then it started happening. And then you started saying it. I was just like, papu, this is what I've been saying for the last 2-3 months. I'm like, papu, I'm feeling it. I'm feeling these little things. And I'm starting to look into it. I'm doing some research on it. Papu, I was trying to take care of the car myself too. Haven't I taken it to like Pep Boys and all that sort of stuff?
And stuff.
Yeah, we've taken care of it. We've done our job to take care of it. Alhamdulillah.
The tires
we avoided. We made sure that we avoided any type of riba, right? And we said that Allah, please take care of it. We got this car at a beautiful price from an auction. And mashallah, we were just like so happy with it. We fell in love with it. It was beautiful, mashallah. It's helped my children get it. Papu has brought home my children. Safely, mashallah, taking them to Sesame Place. So many beautiful things. We had good memories with that car, mashallah.
Both of them. Was the dua? Yeah. Yeah, we got it when dua was born, right?
Yeah, she came home in this car.
Hayat did.
Hayat came home in that car.
Yeah, in the BMW. Video.
You do?
Yeah.
I would love to see
she's
that.
She's in the back.
Is she? Do you have it on your phone?
Let me see. It's going to be difficult. It's somewhere in my Snapchat.
Okay.
And she literally starts crying. And we're telling Dua, you have to look after your little sister. And Dua's like 17 months.
Oh my God. You know what? Dua had to grow up so fast.
Quick, yeah.
Right? And you know what? That's why she's Siani. She's so Siani, mashallah, because, you know, she had to grow up fast. Mashallah. And instead of overly burdening her shoulders, we need to be more supportive of this quality that she has. You know what I mean? We have to be, as parents, reflective about how we're parenting our children. Where do we need to go?
We need to go there, but we got to get back into this lane anyway.
Let's get in this lane. I'm sorry, did I put you in a stressful position?
No.
I'm sorry. You're like,
no, I'm just saying because we got to get back into the right once we get past this.
Yeah.
So I'm just assuming these people are doing the same thing.
Yeah.
So then when I get in the front, then it's going to be a stressful situation because no one's going to let me in.
No. Trust me. Don't anticipate that. Don't worry about that. Don't perceive your situation that way. Perceive it as a way as Allah is developing you to make you a better, stronger driver. That's what it is, John. Papu, that lady cussed you out.
Oh.
Whoa, subhanAllah. That lady, papu, cussed you out and I thought she said something positive. Papu, that's just where my mind goes, papu. Like, how can someone say something negative to you? That's how we perceive it, you know? She's showing her own insecurities, projecting her own insecurities. Papu, you're living, mashallah, alhamdulillah, thanks to the mercy of Allah, your best life. Should we buy some flowers for him? What do you think? You think that's a good idea? No? You sure?
Yeah.
It would help him out. It would help him out. What do you think?
Do it.
And let's get some flowers from her.
Yeah.
Come, let's get some flowers. God bless you, sir. How are you doing?
Okay.
How are you doing? Can I have this? How much is it?
$20.
Huh?
$20.
$20? No problem.
Okay.
It looks like I'm getting married though, my bro. Come on, this is a little too much. Can I put this back? Well, that's a big ass bouquet. $20?
$20.
You don't ever lose money. Here you go, my brother. God bless you.
God bless you.
Thanks so much.
Take care.
Thank you.
No problem. You never lose money. That money just got transformed into a good deed. You thought we lost it? Look how open the window. I don't want you guys to hear this and get demonetized. Look how quiet this cabin is. Bubble, look how quiet this cabin is, mashallah.
Yeah,
you think, Bubble, let me, right now, the 20, did we lose that $20? No. We converted it.
He's going to be spending all day.
He's going to, should we not have helped him because he's a kafir? Be careful, John. Is that a real thing? Come on. He's a creation of Allah. Allah created him. Is it not our responsibility? Yeah, slide in there. MashaAllah. Nice maneuver, John. That was a nice...
Look at him.
Passive-aggressive move.
Traffic.
Oh my God, look at him. He's still not giving you away. What is wrong with you?
Well, he's not
going
to be able to get in front of me because I'm right next to him.
But like, why wouldn't you just give him away? Is that your arrogance? Is that like your arrogance? Like, yo, someone just take down your window and say thank you.
Babe, he's a taxi driver.
But it doesn't matter. Let's show some good manners. Thank you. I hope he doesn't think you're flipping him off.
No, like that.
Yeah, what did you do? What was the sign?
I like that.
Good job, thank you. Or he thinks that you're just... Okay, Papu, so did we lose the money? Did we lose $20 just now? What just happened to our money?
It got doubled.
Oh, doubled? I feel like it just multiplied further. And guess what? The Ashab brothers over there, they just messaged me today about send your expenses. Huh, John? Oh, you got this, babe. You got this maneuver. Don't worry.
This is not an issue. It was them people letting me in.
Oh, man, you got this, babe. Give a thank you to whoever just did that to you.
It's the same person.
Okay, give a thank you again.
He didn't let me in. He was.
It doesn't. Okay, just give a thank you again. He can't see you.
He can see
I'm gonna do it for your behalf. I'm gonna do it on your behalf. May Allah bless you,
sir.
They're
gonna think we're newbies or something.
No, we're Muslims. Papu, look at you. You have a beautiful hijab on. I have a hat on. They know we're Muslims.
Lalo, do you need to drink some water?
I don't think it's a good idea.
She's asleep.
MashaAllah. May Allah bless her. May Allah bless
her. I was supposed to bring her flask.
May Allah bless her. May Allah bless her and guide her. Make her the coolness of our eyes. Look at the du'as we make when she's asleep. Look at the barakah that she has. And she doesn't even know people are making du'a for her. SubhanAllah. And Papu, imagine the du'a for her parents. Isn't the du'a of your parents so powerful?
Hey. I wanted to say something.
Say it.
I wanted the white and red flowers.
Oh,
I didn't want this one.
I'm sorry. But hey, is it okay? Do you think they'll still appreciate it?
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. We'll put a smile. Papu, we just helped him out. Put a smile on his face. Are we going to put a smile on someone else's face?
I was thinking of getting flowers, and then I was like, oh, leave it. I'm not.
SubhanAllah.
And then look,
SubhanAllah.
It came up.
SubhanAllah. And you were supposed to get flowers from him to help his rizq.
Yeah.
SubhanAllah. Papu, did that money just convert into something else? It converted. We didn't lose it, guys. It converted. Nothing's ever lost, Papu. Everything converts into a new form. Like
it's
the
a
same
form
way.
Of charity because you're helping someone that's
it
out there.
Is charity.
He's been probably up since the
grinding.
Morning. He's walking in between cars in the heat. We're sitting in our car in AC.
Think that he's a drug addict?
We could buy it from
Astaghfirullah. He's a hardworking man. He's a hardworking man.
We could buy
a father.
We could buy it from a supermarket.
A husband.
Okay, can I finish my
sentence? I'm sorry. I got dramatic. I'm sorry. I love you. Hey, I'm sorry. Hey, you could say it in a nicer way to me, though. But you got to laugh. You can't be saying it in a serious manner. You got to laugh with it, too. I don't get your British social cues sometimes, all right? I love you.
Yeah, we could have, gone to,
a supermarket.
Shop and shop, whatever. They're not doing no hard graft. They get it delivered. They mark up the prices. Mm.
These guys are working hard.
They're working hard.
And, I teach their children. Don't their children go to the public schools? Mm-hmm. I teach their children. SubhanAllah. What are they going to learn? Something good.
You know, in UK, all the kids went to school today.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Jawad went to first time to secondary school, high school.
Wow. What's that like?
I don't know. I just got a video in the morning of him in his uniform. And my brother was like, oh, he's going to school today.
School is back in session. There needs to be a video about back to school.
Yeah, and then my niece sent me a video saying she's going to her orientation for her sixth form.
Yeah.
The high school.
Wow, mashallah. May Allah bless them. They're good kids too. May Allah increase them. Papu, we just gave a dua. Papu, how strong is the dua of a parent?
Very
right?
Strong.
And do you think that if we're making dua for her, these duas are getting accepted and blessed on her? and she's sleeping. Imagine how many parents are making dua for us. How many people are making dua for us. You know what I mean? We should make dua for each other, guys. Secretly, find someone today and make dua for them. Don't you think that's a cool exercise?
Yeah.
Papu, this video has been going on for 57 minutes. Whoever's going to watch it this far is going to get the best advice of their lives. But if you don't make it this far, that means Allah didn't want you to hear this. Isn't that true?
That's true.
That's true. Ooh, subhanAllah. Ooh, John. Ownership?
No, because everybody
has to Zero ownership. I love you so much.
55 miles an hour. I'm going down to 40, and then the next thing, my money breaks, and it's like zero, and I'm like...
Bro, my car had to remind you to put your brake on.
But I'm just
not
like,
hard enough, maybe. Okay, it's okay.
No, because look, now it's gone...
Thank you for saving us in the family.
Look, now it's gone... The speed has gone back up, so I don't understand how that happened.
Okay, okay. True car. Let's see this, okay? Cayenne, yes or no? Yes or no? No, okay. That mark ahead of us right there. You see that one? Yes or no? Okay. We're just going to keep playing this game. Well, I put barakah in this, okay? I'm just going to show you this. What about something like this for the family? Suburban. No? Okay. I'm just going to keep showing you stuff until we see something that you like. This is the new game we're playing. Does he say you guys need to be interactive with your family? Do you think that's good advice, John?
Yeah.
Be interactive with your family. Be interactive with your children. What about this car right here? Yes. Look at you just said yes. SubhanAllah. May Allah bless you, white lady and white husband and person in the car. We love you. We don't discriminate in Islam. But I just called you white lady because it was funny. Don't think we're being racist. It's just funny, white lady. You know? Yes to that one, huh?
You know what? SubhanAllah.
What do you say?
Gore.
Gore. Gore. We love them. We love them. We just made a dua for them.
Most of our friends are Gore, man.
Well, listen to me. Did we not just make a dua for them?
Yeah.
Okay. We make dua for them. That's the right... Isn't that the right thing to do? Isn't that the right thing to do? I love you. Look how timely that car came too. Huh? How timely that... I could have been sitting there all day. SubhanAllah. And you know what, John? Let me tell you something. My motivation is to get that for you so that people can say that a Muslim woman, you know, like, it feels like... They don't look at him as bichare. You know what I mean? You know, and what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us? Teach us. You know what I mean? To that his bounties and blessings should show. He loves it when his bounties and blessings show. You get what I mean, John?
Mm-hmm.
It should show. And not in an arrogant way. Not in an arrogant way. Not to overextend yourself either. You get what I mean? Not to overextend yourself.
So earlier when I went to CVS,
yeah.
I went through like the back way from Leidig.
Yeah.
And I saw like a lady. She was driving a car, like an older lady with a hijab.
Yeah.
Oh, and mashallah. I was like, mashallah, may Allah bless you. Like, you know, you see that, you feel good.
Yeah. Did you say that to her?
No, she was driving past quite fast. So okay.
May Allah bless her with slower speed, too.
I came around the corner and
what kind of car was it?
It was, I think, like a Camry.
Okay.
Black Camry.
Okay. So you just saw her drive and then...
I seen that she was like maybe mom's age.
Okay.
And she was wearing like a hijab and stuff. And I was like...
God bless you.
I was like, that's amazing.
Hey, do you guys think that we should make a video where we teach our mom how to drive? Do you think that'd be a cool video?
Mom's going to be like, mere good moment.
What do you guys think? What if we got my mom to take a driving lesson with us? I think that'd be a funny video.
Well, technically, she did used to drive.
She used to drive. I think she could. But what if we got a pura kula...
car park
completely empty. I think it'd be fun. We could just have our mom just
be like,
let me tell you something.
You could be like, Nanmo drives a Range Rover.
My grandma drives a Range Rover.
Yeah.
That's a hit.
You get her to do donuts.
Yeah, listen.
She's gonna be doing the, you know, handbrake thing.
Teaching my mom how to drive. That's boring. Grandma does donuts in a Range Rover.
Yeah.
As you clickbaiting us.
She is gonna do it though.
Yeah,
so.
She's gonna do it. We're gonna have her try to do a donut. She's just gonna eat a donut. We're gonna call it that she's doing donuts. Listen. John, I think that'd be a funny video. I need to release. What did I say my next video is gonna be?
You said you were gonna release the sushi.
The sushi video with my father-in-law. May Allah bless him. Good man too. Haji Sadiq. Papuba, I wanted to dub what he says.
Why?
And make it funny. No, and make it funny. Like translating, like every time he says something, I'm gonna say a translation of what it is.
I thought you said dub as in dub his voice. I'm like, why are you gonna do that? He's gonna have people cracking up.
I think he is. And I think that me translating it falsely is gonna make it even funnier. Oh my god. I'm so excited. I'm not going to even like re-edit it. Whatever it is, I'm just going to release it the way it is, okay? I'm not going to overthink it or anything like that. I'm going to try to tune it up.
He just said yum to everything, didn't he?
Yeah. He enjoyed it.
He likes eating different things. It's my mom that's
My father-in-law, he's a foodie.
Yeah.
He's a foodie.
He'll eat anything, but he still has to have his roti salad as well.
How old is he now?
He is 86,
I Allah believe. Bless him. And he has so much energy, mashallah. So much energy, right?
Yeah.
Like he has both knees operate, both knees operated on.
I believe so.
Mashallah, mashallah. He's so active, mashallah.
Now he's had both of his eyes operated.
Subhanallah. There's no stopping this man. Allahumma barik.
I remember, like maybe 20, 30 years ago.
Remember when we found out Grandpa Kitchen died? Oh man, Grandpa! Tell me, you guys watched Grandpa Kitchen? That was good.
Oh, listen.
Yeah, shrimpu.
I remember.
Yeah.
That once. My dad went and had his cataract operation done,
yeah.
And me and my cousin were like, oh, damn, man, now he's going to be able to see us from far away.
Oh, that's funny.
Because we were like, before, he couldn't see us.
That's so funny.
So we were like, now he's going to spot us a mile away.
You used to be proper naughty when you were younger.
No, that's what my mom says. That doesn't technically mean that.
I believe your mom. She's a good woman, mashallah.
No, she believes that's being naughty.
Papu, and you know what? You know how blessed I am? You know how blessed I am? Would you say that your parents love me?
Yes.
They do, right? I think I'm their favorite son-in-law. Be honest. What do you think? Be honest right now. Be honest. I think I'm their favorite son-in-law. Would you agree to that? I think so. Listen, I think I'm their favorite son-in-law.
Listen, I don't want to say anything because I don't want to get people upset. You know who I'm talking about.
Come on. It's okay. You just said it right now without saying it. Okay, thank you. We believe in you. We're 13 minutes away?
This is a cop car, bro. That's an undercover cop.
Oh, man. Come on, copper.
It's like, now I'm going to get a ticket for being like too slow.
Hey, you know what I like about this Rasta, Papu? It didn't break us through the battery tunnel and all that stuff.
I hate that one, right?
This is so much better.
This is the one that when I went to do hijama.
This is so good. I hate the hate is a strong word.
Yeah, but that's the free. That's a strong word.
It's anger. Look at how we have anger towards a bridge. SubhanAllah.
Yeah, but listen, that's the freeway.
Yeah. No, you know? It's not free. We pay mad tolls over there too. Really? Right? But this is the best way to go.
So why would we ever go that
way? Never again. Inshallah, we go this way.
I like coming through the
roads. Plus, this is the way that Allah wanted us to come through. You understand? Those are the days that Allah wanted us to come through. There's no point of like trying to do that. It brought us there safely, didn't it? We had some great biryani too. I need to chill. Man, mashallah, she's such a good cook. We're gonna end this vlog. Maybe I'll decide when I end this vlog. No, I'm gonna do this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides when it ends. Oh. We can put it on. MashaAllah. So good fix, good fix.
Avenue.
Good fix, good fix. It happens.
I thought we took south.
No, it's okay. It happens.
Unless all this traffic.
Yeah, it's trying to fix it up.
Now it's gonna take
nice maneuver, John. Nice last second maneuver. There's nothing wrong with that maneuver. That was well earned.
Oh, we're almost there. I have a new view.
That's what I said. 12 minutes away.
Normally we.
But there's a lot of speed cameras here now. Remember,
yeah, I know.
25. I'm so happy that we came over here. I love coming over here. Wouldn't you say that I love coming here, Jabalkis's house?
Yeah.
Hajan, Papu, remember the first time I saw the children? I came back from the fellows program, right? I've like grown as well.
Yeah.
I came back from the fellows program. Papu, I saw those kids. Did I not cry the first time I did? I was like, wow. I can't wait to introduce you guys to them. Right? Isn't it going to be nice for them to see them too? But I might have to stop this soon. Just to like make sure that like it's being like recorded correctly. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was blessing. Imagine, Papu, no audio is being recorded this whole time. That'd be the will of Allah, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
That'd have been the qadr of Allah. That means I don't use it. MashaAllah. People go out of business, bro. People, look at the Toyota commercial. They're going away before, you know, get them before they're gone. Who the hell is buying them? But boy, the lady told me that the Range Rover, the factory was shut down. Imagine a factory being shut down. They must be desperate. They must be desperate to get them off, but they will never show it. They'll never show it. Like, oh, because they're you know. You think Louis Vuitton doesn't need it, but they would rather look like racist. Papu, did they not kick me out? You saw the video. Did they not kick me out of the store? Hanjan?
They did.
They did. Oh, this is where that mall is, right? This is where that mall is. Did they not kick me out of that store? Did I deserve to get kicked out, John? Be honest, right?
Well, you didn't, but... I mean, there's a lot of stuff going on. People don't know how to act. King's Plaza.
When do I release that video, John? You gotta tell me.
Which one?
The one where the actual footage of kicking out a Muslim and the black guy. From Louis Vuitton.
Maybe after the sushi, I don't know.
Okay, I like that. Oh, did she gave me a 5. I thought I was going to have to give myself a 5. Ooh, it just got like mad cold. I love a cold.
I'm going to be back over here in a bit.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. This is the mall. This is why my wife's over here right now.
They have a Primark in King's Plaza.
Hey, listen to me. I'm sorry for showing your face earlier. I didn't mean to.
Just put an emoji.
I will. Hey, do you like when I do that with the emoji? Yeah? MashaAllah.
King's Plaza Mall.
Oh, I wish I would have come too. I wouldn't mind coming.
No,
I'm gonna play some 2K with the kids. I'm gonna play some 2K with the kids, inshallah. Primark, we love you, Primark. Primark was a game changer. But I remember when I went to go marry you in the UK, November. You still remember that? When I came, you picked me up, picked my family up. Remember that, John? Was that not a good time?
But you know, Primark is better in the UK than here.
It is. It definitely is. But wasn't that a nice time? Mm-hmm. Wasn't that so special to us? We forget how much like that meant to us, John. We take each other for granted. You get me? Some buzzies. Do you guys spot other Muslim people too? We do. We look for other Muslim people. We're like, ah, we found you. We found you. Going over there. Go to Five Below. Go to JCPenney. We've seen you, Macy's. This place that we're going has a lot of Jewish people, too. A lot of Jewish people.
Yeah, it's a neighborhood full of Jewish people.
There's nothing wrong with
that. Yeah, I mean,
there's nothing
wrong
with
that. You go near the masjid.
Yeah.
On Rylander, that's full of Yemeni people, so, you know.
Muslims who happen to be Yemeni.
It's just where people start living in it. Come on, where I'm from, the whole town is Mirpuri.
Your whole bladri is there, bro.
Not just our bladri, even our bloody relatives and their whole tabbas.
Wow.
And their next door neighbors.
This is High Wycombe.
Yeah.
High Wycombe. High Wycombe is filled with just like apne. Everyone is just, it's like Pakistan, Papu. I felt like I'm in Pakistan.
The only like Gore people are...
Oh, may Allah protect us. Someone broke in their windshield. Astaghfirullah.
The only Gore people
Papu,
are...
Papu, isn't this a better Rasta?
Maybe.
Right? Look how quiet this Rasta was.
The only Gore people are people that go to university in Wycombe. Otherwise,
isn't that the same thing over here? The only Gore people over here are in Fordham University.
Yeah.
That's otherwise, why there's no white people in the Bronx.
They're buying houses and living.
Well, there are. That was mad ignorant of me. I don't mean it like that, right? But like, you know, white people who probably were like living here earlier are in the Bronx, but like no one else is really settling. But everybody wants to live in Brooklyn.
Proper white.
But Papu, everyone wants to live in Brooklyn, right?
Yeah.
Manhattan.
Yeah.
Maybe Harlem, the white part of Harlem. That's just what it is, bro.
But you know what's sad?
What's sad?
That when you say you're from the Bronx, people...
assume negativity towards that.
They just go like, oh, really? Is it safe?
Buffalo?
And you're like, bro...
There's a million-dollar house.
Yeah, I'm like, the street away from me, there's million-dollar houses with people that are driving Ferraris living in the Bronx.
Yeah.
And they're like, what?
Nice
and said,
cars.
And I'm like, people have swimming pools in their garden. They're like, really?
Yeah.
They just think it's some sort
when people come over for
hijaba.
I looked at hijab and said hijaba. Okay, may Allah preserve our smiles and laughter. I mean, see what I mean? Okay, so when people come for hijama, don't they get surprised about how nice our area is?
Yeah.
How nice our clinic is,
it's
mashallah.
Papu,
think about this.
That's
nice. Look, that's a nice park.
Yeah.
That's a nice, we should take them here.
There's only one kid.
Okay.
I think it's unfair to take her
We bring dua.
When we have dua, we bring.
Okay, that's a nice park. Let me
nice
show you guys. Maybe you guys can see, maybe you guys can't. I'm sorry.
It's like a snake and it has a sprinkler.
That's nice.
Right? Look, from its mouth, there's a sprinkler.
Okay, so babe, isn't the new area that we're going to even better? City Island area? Inshallah.
Inshallah. Allah wills. If it's good for us, inshallah.
Simple.
Yeah.
$1 million houses over there?
Yeah.
Yeah? Bronx. That's
it's
the Bronx.
Part of the Bronx. This is what people don't realize. Like, anywhere
perception.
You live, there will be places Buffalo, that are bad.
I came to High Wycombe, right? I told people I'm from the Bronx, oh, are there drive-by theirs? I'm like, drive-by theirs? Like, obviously there are bad areas wherever you go. Even in Manhattan, there's bad areas in Manhattan, right? You know? But people just have this negative connotation. And guess what, Papu? If I'm able to be like this huge, huge person from the Bronx to come out, you could put the Bronx in a positive I could be the Muslim Casey Neistat. Did Casey Neistat save my YouTube channel?
Yes, he did.
He did. That's a true story. Inshallah, it's coming to a store near
Casey
you.
Casey Neistat was in that movie as well.
Oh, yeah, smashed yeah. Smashed it, Casey. Hey, do you think... Babu, like, I honestly, what do I always tell you about...
His partner doesn't like being in the videos either.
Who? His partner, he doesn't. Yeah. Clearly, she doesn't. She doesn't.
When he pulls the camera...
What's her name? I forgot her name. I forgot the sister's name. Who knows, Babu? They could be become friends. Who knows? Is that not possible for me and Casey Neistat to become good friends? That's what happens when people have couples and stuff like that. They tend to be gravitate more. Why? Because you have children, you're married, and people, when you're married, you only hang out with married people generally. Not always.
Not necessarily.
Know? But hey, but think about us and Ibrahim. Us and Ibrahim. Could Casey and I have become a Muslim? Why not? We don't know that. I believe you can.
I think you hang around with all types of people.
I do.
Not just married, not single, not old, not young, not your age.
Are you saying me or
you?
Me. Would you say it for real?
Yeah.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
That's a good thing.
Yeah? I feel like that's such a compliment from you. Thank you, babe. I thought that was such a nice kind of thing for her to say to me. That's so nice. Whoa. These glasses are super bright. Like, they're dark. I hope you guys like this. Put the Bronx on the map. For positivity.
I thought J-Lo did.
No. I seen J-Lo in Palestine. Remember? I told you that. Is that true? That's true, right? I'm not making that up. I showed you the footage.
She hasn't really done much for the Bronx, has she?
No. She's forgotten. She's forgotten about the Bronx. I'm not forgetting about the Bronx. I'm going to live here. I'm going to make this place better. Teach in the schools over here. Huh? Papu, how much more impactful could I be as a teacher and a YouTuber at the same time? Don't you think? Papu, do you think my students... Don't I always call my students my children? Mm-hmm. Don't I always? Isn't that the truth? Allah's my witness. Babu, don't you think I could do so much more being a YouTuber and a teacher at the same time? You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely, because you have more impact. But you do also need to focus on your...
Education.
Job. Yeah, their education. The thing is, you know...
Babu, when they love you, they'll learn from you. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Listen to what I just said. When they love you, they'll learn from you. Did people not love the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? So did they not want to learn from him? Yeah. They never wanted to leave him. True? Mm-hmm. Isn't that true? When they love you, they want to learn from you. If your children can love you, they'll learn from you. Sah? True? Right? Then can I teach them math? Will they learn? Yeah. Will they be open to giving it a try? Right? Because they love you. And they'll learn from you.
The thing is, you know what it is? You have to yourself... be in a good place to be able
Agreed.
To make
Agreed.
Children
Agreed.
Feel good. Because you have to remember that at home, especially after COVID, what they've probably been through, like, you know, what's going on at home, money's tight, you know, domestic violence, all this stuff, man.
Yeah.
So my point is you have to be in a good place yourself before you can, you know, make someone else feel good.
Hey, let me ask you a question. You know, do you think that you would throw me like a halal get together celebration party kind of thing if I hit 100,000 subscribers?
Yeah, why not?
Would you like do something nice for me? No, I'm not saying to do it. Like, would that be something that you would do, or it's just like, it doesn't matter because that's just nowhere where you really need to be right now. You know what I mean?
Get you a cake.
You would?
Yeah.
Nice. Aw, you're
I
the best.
I always get you balloons.
You do? My wife always gets me balloons. Balloons make me so happy, but guess who uses them?
The kids.
So it makes them happy. So do you know how big of a barakah it is? It's okay to get a person a balloon. It doesn't mean that you're celebrating a birthday or something like that.
No,
it makes
it
them feel good.
When I get you balloons, it doesn't say happy
It's just
birthday.
A nice birthday.
It says I love you. It
yeah, and you write something
face,
on it. And sometimes you write
on it.
It makes the person feel nice. It doesn't mean you're celebrating that day. For your birthday, what did I get you?
For my birthday.
Well, what did I get you for your birthday?
My birthday coming up? Or
your birthday coming up.
Oh, a massage and facial.
A spa session. A spa day. Why not? So does that mean that you're celebrating your birthday, or am I just doing something special for you on your birthday? Which one is it? Does that mean we celebrate? No. But can I make someone feel special on that day with love and appreciation?
So
do you think
is,
that she's like not going to pray on that day?
You know what it is? Some people believe that, you shouldn't do it
around your birthday, do it after because it means that you're doing it. No, it's the month of my birthday and I want to treat myself.
And it's not happening on your birthday.
No, it's not even on my birthday. It's just the month of my birthday.
Because that's the Saturday we could squeeze.
And the thing is, like, I just don't have time to, like, invest in myself.
So
like
I'm taking care of the kids?
So you're taking care of the kids so I can go and I can just rejuvenate.
That's the right thing. Listen to what she said, rejuvenate. Shouldn't we be giving people that opportunity?
Because I am with kids all day long.
Come on. That could drive you insane. Look, someone's moving out or moving in. Which one is it?
They're moving in.
They're moving in. May Allah bless them. Put barakah in their house and allow them to pray in their homes and obey Allah and worship Allah. I mean, man, this vlog, lesson nice, mashallah, is an hour and 18 minutes. Those who are going to watch are going to watch it, correct?
Correct.
Right? Should that worry me how long it is?
No.
It shouldn't. I should just post as long as I want to.
You should, like, fast forward stuff.
Yeah?
I think that's fun as well. Like, you know, like when people have, like, the camera and then they just
But if I'm saying something...
And then they're like, do-do-do-do-do-do with, like, the thing in the background. I think
but we don't use well. Music, but
no,
what
I'm
saying...
No, but you could just use well, that, or something.
Yeah, mashallah. That's a nice place too, right? So, babe, listen to this, right? If I'm not talking, but that's fine. But for an hour and 18 minutes, we've been talking. You know what I mean? You get me, babe. For an hour and 18 minutes, we've been talking.
Whoa.
Oh, man.
Grandpa.
You know, I love the elderly, John, but I don't think they should be driving on the roads.
Oh, that's wrong.
No. It's not. Let me tell you why. You know why?
In the UK, they have to retake their test.
That's the right thing to do is also. Let me tell you why.
My dad had to retake the test. He's failing, bro.
Bro, listen to me. Can I just say this, John? Because their children should be doing their khidmat. That's why. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but the thing is, I'm not being funny, but with Gure, they don't.
Yeah.
So they rather have their independence than get put into our old people's home.
Okay, but hear me out, right? Hear me out. I would want them to have the ability to drive.
I feel so bad when I see older, like, Gure people. Like, I feel sad for them. You get me?
They probably feel sad for themselves.
Yeah, I'm just
knowing that, like, they took care of children their whole life, and then it was a time for them to get older, and no one took care of them. Okay, now we're looking for parking right here, maybe? Bismillah? Oh, that's a hydrant.
Yeah,
okay,
you always do that. I was looking across there.
Okay, let's make a right, inshallah, at the light. Hey, and another, this is not a stressful time. We'll find whatever parking is meant for our name. Okay, babe? Don't worry about it. Make a right over here, inshallah. Okay, make a right, inshallah. We're going to find the best spot, inshallah. Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa ant. You couldn't have been a thalimeen. We should be asking Allah's help for everything. When it comes to finding parking, everything. Because the parking spot that Allah has to find for us has to be good for our deen, our dunya, our akhirah. Right?
Mm-hmm.
For our protection of our property. This might not be a nice spot, but maybe head there something. You know? Something good for our akhirah. Something protection for our car, you know, from getting hit or stolen or broken into or something. Whatever Allah does is for our best. It's for our benefit. True? Huh, John? Whatever Allah does, that's the driveway. Whatever Allah does for us is for our benefit. True, John?
Mm-hmm.
True. I love having this conversation with you. Mika, right from here.
What's my friend here doing?
He's struggling.
Is he trying to park or does he want me to go?
This is, he's doing bad communication right now. It's really bad communication. Cars, can we go? Thank you. It's just really bad car communication. Like, you need to put hazard lights on. Like, for that big truck.
Go down that.
Yeah, make a right, baby. I love parking over there, by the way. Is my baby up? Hey, baby.
Hello.
Hey, you're up from your nap?
I found a plant.
Hey, did you say Alhamdulillah?
Yeah, Daddy got flowers. I
did. Hey, Janu, did you say Alhamdulillah for waking up? Allah put life back into you. Isn't that true, John? Allah put life back into her. No. Remember, our spot is over there.
Look at this.
Yeah, they're waiting
to get that car.
So
no, he's going to pull that car
yeah,
up.
Yeah.
Me, yes,
no. I know, Mini John, it's a hydrant. Oh, you're so right. You're so right, baby. You're so thoughtful, Haya.
Yeah.
That's so thoughtful of you. What did you just say?
I'd like to make you a plant tree.
Yeah, that plan is actually for Hala Belkis. But you know what? Maybe we should get Mommy Nemo a plant too, right? We should do nice things for each other. What should we get for Dua when she returns?
He will get a bed plant for Dua.
Now for Dua, we have the walkie-talkie and the Queen Poppy writing board.
For me?
She hasn't even called us.
Well, I guess they're busy. She's on a call. She doesn't have a phone call.
No, but like she didn't even ask for us. Her children has left us. She's left us. Papa, one day she's going to be old and leave us when she gets married.
She's going to get smacks from me if she does that.
Hey, hey, hey. Sit back, Nijan. Remember safety. You've been such a good girl since I gave you that reminder. It was nasiha from your father, Nijan. That's all it was. This is not. Plus, I don't know if you want to park here. Make a right at the light. Usually we find sparks up there. Right, baby? Hey, sit down correctly, Nijan. Sit down correctly. Legs closed correctly, Nijan.
Please refuel.
Yeah, we're going to get gas from there, inshallah. It's normal priced. Hey. Hey, listen to me. I love you. This was one of the best conversation rides I've ever had in my life. Thank you for that.
Hey, we've had a lot of them.
We have. We had great ones. But hey, this is one that is up there. Okay? It was like awesome. And I just feel like my love and appreciation for you has grown so much more. May Allah forgive me for all my shortcomings. What do you think if I got a motorcycle, John?
No. this is too close.
I thought I'd shoot my shot. No. I can't shoot you. I can't look there. Maybe behind him, maybe. But no. Nah. This is us trying to find parking, by the way. This is a vlog reminder. It's long. They told me, SQ, make your videos shorter. SQ done made it even longer. SubhanAllah. It's okay, we'll find a spot. We'll find a spot, inshallah. This is the spot. No. Hide your hand. I'm so sorry. I'm just guiding you. Make a right over here, John. This is the spot. Can you get in here? If you can't, it's okay. We'll find something else. My wife is about to kill this, inshallah. My wife is about to kill this, inshallah. Say bismillah. Bismillah. MashaAllah. So proud of your parking, John. What an amazing job. Do you need me to get out or you think you're going to be okay? She's going to be good, inshallah. What a beautiful job you just did.
MashaAllah.
Allahu Mubarak. It's good. It's going to be a nice walk for us after we eat all that biryani. Okay? It's going to be good for us. Hey, we're going to join the gym together, inshallah. Huh, John? Good job. Good job. So remember on my birthday when I had that accident? SubhanAllah. And you know what you did? What did you do? You brought me this stuff. You brought me
John. Look, me. You just left. We've got to pass
that. No, it's okay. We're in already, John. We're in already. Cut. It was his. Yes, mashallah. What a beautiful job you're doing. What a beautiful job you're doing. Okay, well, I'm just recording your greatness, mashallah. I'm so proud of you. So proud of you, John. That was such a tight spot. I can't wait to show the people what kind of spot this was. Okay?
Yeah, but my back is out.